You're listening to the best Radio VPS.
The original.
There is no competition. There is no competition.
All technical difficulties has been taken care of by the super producer, B. Brown.
Yeah, man, I had to have something to drink, man. I ain't had my breakfast this morning.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Get some
that
caffeine
McDonald's.
Or something.
Get
you know?
That McDonald's.
A V8 to set me straight or something.
Yeah, man, we got it all together now. We done worked out the kinks. That was Casanova's new joint, Left, Right. And that was Chris Brown rapping and fabulous. Chris Brown
got some bars, man. Y'all
that's
don't
the
know.
Problem with music today, man. Why do you have R&B people trying to spit?
But he can, though. There's a difference.
Back in the day, you ain't hear Luther with 16, with a fresh 16.
But Luther couldn't drop. Luther couldn't drop a fresh 16.
Hey, you heard Michael Bivins spit and Ronnie
DeVoe.
What else was Michael Bivins going to do? He can't sing. Cut it out.
But
I know he can't sing.
They had a little harmony going on.
He cannot sing, man. Cut it out. He was the hip-hop part of the group. Come on,
man. Man, Michael sang lead on Competition.
Who?
That was a song. It was a beat.
That
cut
was an
on
album filler. That was a filler. All their hits was sung by who?
Ralph
and Bobby
and Johnny.
Well, that was.
And hold on, Ricky. Ricky was the singer of BBD. Look,
you can't talk about New Edition around these two OGs because they swear they was New Edition back in the day.
Hey man, they New Edition is the truth. Shout out to New Edition.
They swear they was New Edition, but this is. Not the new edition of the OG Hood Fellas. This is the beef edition of the OG Hood Fellas. And we got more beef to discuss, man. I'm talking about Love and Hip Hop.
Oh, man.
Love and Hip Hop beef in Atlanta. And you know when we talking about Love and Hip Hop in Atlanta, we got a Stevie J is always in the middle of it.
Stevie.
Yeah, Stevie J and Johnny Blaze. They went at it a couple days ago on social media. He beefing with Johnny Blaze because of this right here. Take a look. Stevie, yeah, she hit him off. You know, she ain't got no cut card in that. They made a couple sex tapes. She talking about, go ahead, put him out, nigga, who cares? You know what I'm saying? Johnny just going hard, man. That's how she go.
Yeah.
She mad, and Stevie made a video, but he took it down. So I figured he was wrong in the situation because he made a video and he took it down.
Duh, moment. Yeah. All right. It seems like for every Cardi B, for every K Michelle, who else done popped off for Love and Hip Hop?
Them the only two.
For every when Remy was already popping, so
right.
I can't even
nah,
claim
you can't
her.
Count Remy.
But look at all the lives that she just ruins. Yeah?
I don't think she ruins them though, because we wouldn't even know them if it wasn't for Mona.
Because all the ghetto ratchet broads want to get married too. So they gonna be like, look, bitch, we winning.
But
we winning, bitch.
Everybody
we
not. It's different from when you marrying a Grammy Award winning artist to a nigga from the Bronx.
Again.
It's a little different.
You're proving my point. Look, bitch, we winning.
I guess, man.
You wanna know why? You wanna know why?
Man, his money. Ross say Wayne is his little homie. And he talking directly to Baby. He said, pay that man his money and stop with all the jokes about the murder because you know where I'm at. Both of them live in Miami.
I mean, it ain't that tough.
Both of them live in Miami.
She going to try to find some rapper. She going to try to find some rapper or some ball player that she can get knocked up by and flip that into a reality show. And
but
she'll be
y'all
straight.
Know she in the studio. She about to be a
what?
Cardi B.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, she been in the studio. She was in the studio with all kinds of big name producers. So I told y'all, man, it's about your followers and how you doing on social media. These record labels going to make
you
a star.
Well,
it ain't about
quit.
Talent.
I can't do
speaking
this no more.
It ain't about talent.
Speaking of following, man, be sure to follow the OGs at OGHFZ on all social media. We can get our social media following up so we can get a endorsement deal of some sort, right?
Oh, right. Yeah, we definitely need that endorsement deal.
Right. So hit me up on I Hate Lito. That's I Hate Dot Lito. I put a dot in the middle because I'm
You special. Hit me up at Dame Fresh OGHZD. Man, just find
A-B-C-D-E.
Me shit.
ABCDE.
He don't even know his social media.
And B Brown INC.
Yeah, that's the B Brown INC. Hit him up. And Dame is just out of sync because China has a record deal.
I can't, dog.
Hold on, I bet you a manager, though.
I mean, I definitely would.
Garbage or no garbage.
Straight up. So, and that's D Fresh OGHF.
Hold on. So you a manager so you can get some bread off her, but you don't believe in her talent?
Hey, man.
He gonna say, hey, man. So you know what that means when they say amen. Mm-hmm. Amen, huh? Okay. All right, amen.
Who would turn down that opportunity if it came?
But you don't believe in their talent. Why would you manage something you don't believe in?
Hey, man.
Once again, it's hey, man.
Groundhog Day.
Right, this nigga just keeps saying, hey, man. Hey, man.
What would you do? You saying, so you wouldn't manage her? If she came to you right now and said, Lito, I need you to manage
her. Not if I didn't believe in the talent.
You are fucking lying.
I wouldn't.
Yo, you would manage her for two reasons. One, because you could get that bag with her. And two, you're one step away from Amber.
Shit.
Thank you.
That's a monkey wrench in the game. But I wouldn't need the manager to do that. I'd just take the meeting and then be like, but if Amber was with you.
It is on.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's why I just take the meeting.